This fabulation deals entirely with the film side and with the vehicles indwelt by the logos, luminosity written by man. 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The subjective development. This is also sevenfold, astral, kama manas, pure desire, emotion, feeling, desire mind, manas, higher manas, buddy, atma, monadic, lower concrete mind, abstract or pure mind, pure reason, intuition, pure will, realization, will, love, wisdom, intelligence. This deals with the sevenfold development of inherent love, wisdom by the aid of mind. This proceeds macrocosmically through the seven heavenly men, who are 168 ACREATIONSOMICFIRE. Actively intelligent, inherently love, and are objectively seen through their forms, the planetary speech. In their totality, they are the Logos, the Grand Man of the Heavens. In the case of a heavenly man, the development proceeds through the seven groups of human entities who form their psychic centers. These groups are on their own plane developing intelligence, are inherently loved, and can be objectively contacted on the seven chains of a speech. In the case of individual man, the development proceeds through the seven centers, which are the key to his psychic evolution. A man is also developing intelligence, is inherently loved, and is objectively seen through one or other of his bodies. What I seek to emphasize is the fact of the psychic development, and also that subjective evolution is the main enterprise of the Logos, of a planetary Logos and of a man. Active intelligent love, the bringing forth from latency of the inherent quality of love by the intelligent application of the mind faculty will be the result of the evolutionary process. Just as objectivity is dual, life form, so subjectivity is dual, mind love, and the blending of the two produces consciousness. Spirit alone is unity, and is undivided. The development of spirit, or its assumption of the fruits of evolution, is only to be realized and brought about when the dual evolution of the form of the psyche is consummated. Then spirit garners the fruits of evolution and gathers to itself the qualities nurtured during manifestation. Perfect love and perfect intelligence showing forth then as active intelligent love wisdom. Who am I, therefore, answer the question, what is the mind aspect and why is it so important? By saying that the mind aspect is in reality the ability or capacity of the mobility system to think, to act, to build, and to evolve in order to develop the faculty of active love. When the Logos, who is active intelligence, have run his INTROGENITORYQUESTIONS 269 cycle, he will be also love fully manifested throughout nature. This can be likewise predicated of a heavenly man in his sphere and of a man in his tiny cycle. Thus the importance of manas can be fully seen. It is the means whereby evolution becomes possible, comprehension is achieved, and activity is generated and legalized. Let us now consider how this question can be expressed in terms of fires.